Hello, I'm Professor Von Schmohawk, and welcome to Why You. In the last lecture, we saw how systems of two linear equations in two variables could be solved to find one solution which simultaneously satisfies both equations. We know that the set of solutions for each equation is visually represented by its graph, and each equation's graph is made up of an infinite number of points. The x and y coordinates of each point representing one particular solution. Any point which lies on both graphs, in other words, any intersection point of the two graphs, therefore represents a solution which is common to both equations. We call the process of finding the coordinates of these intersection points solving a system of equations. In the last lecture, we solved systems of two linear equations using the substitution method to find values for x and y which simultaneously satisfy both equations. These values are the x and y coordinates of the intersection point of the graphs. In this lecture, we will introduce another method of solving a system of equations called the elimination method. When solving a system of linear equations using the elimination method, the equations are normally written in standard form. As we saw in the lecture on standard form, equations in two variables x and y are written with a single x term and y term on the left side and a single constant on the right. So let's say we have a system of two linear equations we wish to solve. The elimination method involves adding the two equations in a way that eliminates one of the variables. For example, to add these equations, we add the x terms, the y terms, and the constant terms to create a new equation. Since the y term in the first equation is 3y, and the y term in the second equation is negative 3y, the sum of these terms is 0, and the y term is eliminated from the resulting equation. This equation can now be solved for the remaining variable x. Dividing both sides by 3, we get x equals 18 over 3, or x equals 6. Now that we know the value of x, we can set the value of x in either equation to 6 and find the corresponding value of y. Either equation will give us the same answer. In this example, since the second equation is the simpler of the two, we will use it to find the value of y. Setting x to 6, we can now solve this equation for y by subtracting 6 from both sides, giving us the equation negative 3y equals 3 minus 6, or negative 3. Dividing both sides by negative 3, we see that y is equal to negative 3 over negative 3, or 1. So the values of x and y, which simultaneously solve both equations, are 6 and 1. Starting with this same system of equations, instead of eliminating the variable y, we could have eliminated x. Simply adding these equations will not eliminate the variable x, since the x terms don't cancel. However, we can rewrite the second equation to make the x terms cancel by multiplying both sides by negative 2. Distributing the negative 2 multiplier to the terms in parentheses, we get negative 2x minus negative 2 times 3y, which we can write more simply as plus 6y. This is equal to negative 2 times 3, or negative 6. The x terms in these equations will now cancel when the equations are added. This gives us 9y equals 9. And dividing both sides by 9, we get y equals 9 over 9, or y equals 1. The value of y in either equation can then be set to 1, and the equation solved for x. Since both equations appear equally difficult, we will arbitrarily choose the top equation. We can now solve this equation for x by subtracting 3 from both sides, giving us the equation 2x equals 15 minus 3, or 2x equals 12. Dividing both sides by 2, we see that x equals 12 over 2, or 6. So once again, we have found that the values of x and y, which solve this system of equations, are 6 and 1. When using the elimination method, it may sometimes be impossible to cancel terms by choosing an integer multiplier for only one of the equations. For example, in this system, there is no integer multiplier which we can choose for the first equation, which will result in an x coefficient of negative 3 or a y coefficient of negative 7 to cancel the coefficients of 3 or 7 in the second equation. Likewise, there is no integer multiplier for the second equation, which will result in an x coefficient of negative 2 or a y coefficient of negative 5 to cancel the coefficients of 2 or 5 in the first equation. However, there are integer multipliers we can pick for both equations, which will make either the x or y terms disappear when the equations are added. For example, let's say we would like to eliminate the x terms. If we multiply the first equation by the second equation's x coefficient, and the second equation by the first equation's x coefficient, once we distribute the multipliers, the x terms in both equations will have coefficients of 6. So if we flip the sign of one equation's multiplier, the x terms will cancel when the equations are added. Before adding, we must first distribute the multipliers to the terms in parentheses. Then we complete the arithmetic in both equations. Starting with the x terms, 3 times 2 is 6, and negative 2 times 3 is negative 6. In the y terms, 3 times 5 is 15, and 2 times 7 is 14. And completing the arithmetic on the right sides, 3 times 1 is 3, and negative 2 times 2 is negative 4. The x terms will now cancel when the equations are added. This gives us the equation y equals negative 1. The value of y in either equation can then be set to negative 1, and the equation solved for x. Replacing y in the top equation with negative 1, we complete the arithmetic, multiplying 15 times negative 1 to get negative 15. Adding 15 to both sides, we have 6x equals 3 plus 15, or 6x equals 18. And dividing by 6, we get x equals 18 over 6, or 3. So the values of x and y, which simultaneously solve both equations, are 3 and negative 1. As we saw, the elimination method involves adding equations to get a new equation that eliminates one of the variables. The justification which is usually given for this process is that since it is okay to add the same thing to both sides of an equation, then two equations can be added, since both sides of the second equation are equal and are therefore the same thing. However, this does not tell the whole story, since adding two equations creates an equation whose solution set is different from either of the original equations. In the next lecture, we will see what happens when two equations are added and why this works for the elimination method.